Today we will discuss about the instrumentation of electrogrammetry. There are various methods of electrogrammetry. First we will see the constant current methods. The instruments is as shown in figure. It consists of a cell. Here we see the constant current method. In constant current method, it is provided the direct power supply of 6 to 12 volt. The voltage is applied and it is the controlled by resistance. The whole apparatus, it is known as the cell. Cell, it is the like it is the beaker. It consists of two electrodes. One, it is the cathode and anode electrode. Cathode, it is the negative electrode, and anode, it is the positive electrodes. Here cathode, it is known as, also known as the working electrodes. Cathode, it is the large surface area. Here we will see the cathode. Here it is the negative end, cathode, and anode, it is the positive end. So cathode, it is the large surface area. It is the platinum gauge and it is the cylindrical, 2 to 3 cm in diameter and up to 6 cm in length. So in platinum electrode, platinum we does not measure the bismuth, zinc, gallium. So these are decays the platinum electrode. So for bismuth, zinc and gallium, we use the copper electrode. So the cathode electrodes are working electrode. Here is the platinum gauge and anode. Here anode, it is the solid platinum rod, is attached to rotating motor to supply the electrical and supply the electrical current. So here anode, it is the rotating, and cathode is the gauge shape. So in cylindrical wiring shape, cathodes and anode. Anode is moving or rotating to avoiding the polarization effect. So this is the constant current method. So in this constant current method, we use the 6 to 12 volt. For the constant current method, it is attached ammeter for measuring current, voltmeter measuring voltage, and here a supply of battery, 6 to 12 volt. As shown in earlier, a thin net like a structure, circular structure. This is the cathode and this is the anode. Cathode and anode is inserted in a beaker and supply a voltage and ammeter. So this is all known as the constant current method. So next method, it is the controlled potential electrogrammetry. So in controlled potential electrogrammetry, they are using the three electrodes. One, it is the working electrode. Second is the counter electrode. And third, it is the reference electrode. Working electrode, it is the cathode. Counter electrode, the anode. And working electrode, the standard Calomel electrode we use. So there is a large negative drift in cathode potential. This can be avoided by three electrode system. Here it is, we use the three electrode system. In earlier we use only two electrode, cathode and anode. Here we use the reference electrode as a standard Calomel electrode. So the reference electrode, it is the current of reference electrode is zero in all the time of time. Here attach the digital voltmeter and voltage applied between working and here working electrode and counter electrode is adjusted by a contact C. This is all control potential electrogravimetry. So the control potential electrogravimetry, the instrumentation in three electrode system. So sometime we use the mercury as the cathode electrodes. In certain application, electrolytic reductions are performed with mercury cathodes or advantages. The electrode is generally used in removing easily reduced elements. When we determine the metal ions, the precipitated element dissolve in mercury. Copper, nickel, cobalt, silver and cadmium are readily separated from the aluminium, titanium, phosphate and alkali metals. The mercury cathode for electrolytes removal of metal ions from the solutions is like in the figure. Here it is the solutions and separated the metal ions.